There's been around 2,000 deaths linked to COVID in Scottish care homes. Tonight, we can reveal a major police investigation is actively underway, its scope eventually to investigate them all.
These are the very first details of what's been called Operation Copper. Care homes have been given 14 days by police to produce reams of information about COVID deaths. And we understand that some carers have already spent hours being questioned.
Leaked documents seen by Channel 4 News detail 37 questions for care homes from the police regarding each COVID-linked death. They must also supply copies of staff rotas, even floor plans and PPE invoices. It's happening on instruction of the Crown Office in Scotland, who say this doesn't mean a crime is being investigated, but also that it may be decided that a death should be the subject of a fatal accident inquiry or prosecution.
Frontline carers, frontline nurses are knackered, they're exhausted. And on top of their exhaustion, they are now having to be interviewed, to undertake examination of files and records, to produce those. And it's causing a real emotional distress.
Alan's mum, Helen, died in a Scottish care home in May.
I would have been happier with the public inquiry, I think. But we're not getting one of those anytime soon, so let the police do their thing.
The Scottish Government supports some form of inquiry, but in August, Nicola Sturgeon said a public inquiry now would divert attention from keeping people safe. Today, the First Minister stuck to that position.
Should the government and yourself not be held to the same standard as hard-working frontline carers?
Yes, I think we should be held to a high standard, but I also think part of being held to a high standard is not taking my eye off the ball of dealing with this situation now.
The leader of the Scottish Conservatives says he wants the police investigation and a public inquiry.
Is it hypocritical of you to be saying the Scottish Government should be holding a public inquiry now when your colleagues in the Westminster Government are refusing to hold one at all?
Well, I want to see both the UK Government and the Scottish Government learn through this pandemic and ensure that any mistakes that have been made are not repeated. And that's the same here in Scotland as it is anywhere in the United Kingdom.
So far, more than 300 care home residents and health workers' deaths have been reported to Operation Copper. That number will grow. But some carers are asking tonight if their actions are being investigated, shouldn't the government's too?